Today, I'll actually make an app program with PowerApps. Hi, this is Magnigami, Lean Sigma, Black Belt. I introduced Microsoft PowerApps in the last video. Today, I'll show you a demonstration of actually making a simple app program. But I want to show you the step-by-step usage this time because I want you to grasp the whole picture of the process to make an app. If you have Office 365 Business Essentials or higher installed in your computer, you can use Power Apps for free. It may be already in your company's computer. Please sign in from office.com. Power Apps is a cloud program, so you can use it from any computer. It's very convenient. This is the home screen of Power Apps. From here, if you click on Run and Get Started, you can learn how to use this program step by step. Now, let's start making an application. Click on Apps, then Create an App. Here, you can choose to make from blank or from data. At the beginning, it's better to make from data. I prepared a Major League Baseball standing list with Excel. When you use Excel data, there are very important points you should be aware of. I'll talk about those details in the next video, but I'll mention only one thing today. It's that you have to put your data in a table. This is my data. You just select the data range and click Home, Format as Table, then choose the format you like. It will be named Table 1. By saving this file in the cloud, you can use this data from any device. This time I saved in Google Drive. Let's go back to Power Apps. Select Google Drive. Since I've signed in to my Google account on this computer, I can easily connect to it. After the authentication screen, I can find the file I just saved. I'll select the file and see and select Table 1 and click Connect. Now it's saying building your app. It looks like PowerApp is building an app for us. Yes, it made it for us. Of course, it can't read our mind, so we have to customize it for our purpose, but it's much faster and easier than making it from scratch. First, I'll change Table 1 above to today's MLB standings. It looks better. I want to see the team names on the first screen. Click Data Sources here. You can replace data with other data, so you can bring in any data you like. I would like more data here. You just need to copy and paste a text box. I'll fix this layout to look good without writing code. You can work intuitively. Let's see the preview with this triangle-shaped button. You can sort the ranking this button. If you select a team, details of the result of that team will appear on the next screen. You can edit the data by pressing this pen icon. Delete the data with this trash can icon. You can also add new data with this plus button. If I share this app with others and update the source data every day, it will be an app that shows the latest MLB standings. In that case, since I don't want users to edit or add data, I deleted those buttons. It's very simple app, but it's complete. I'll save the app as today's MLB standings by clicking save. Then it's done. It's also easy to share this app with your team on this screen. When using this app on tablet, first install the PowerApps app in your device. After logging into my Microsoft account from the app, the file name of today's MLB standings appears like this. Yeah, tap on it and I can use my app. Since you can make apps so easily and for free with PowerApps, it can be used in various situations from now on. For example, you could make a price list app for your outside salespeople. Even a small store can make an inventory check app. This is a totally new era. We can make process improvement innovations very easily. Please let me know what kind of apps you'd like to make with PowerApps in the comment section below. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.